Welcome. Have you recently had the annoying problems of your mouse lagging or jumping from one part of the screen to another on Windows? Today, I will show you the most ultimate solutions you will try out to fix a lagging, jumping, or slow mouse cursor in Windows 10. I assume the mouse is still working a little bit. While I'm going to show you everything here with the mouse, I have a link to a cheat sheet in the description below this video with keyboard shortcuts to attain the same results, just in case your mouse is not working at all. As usual, if you find this video helpful, please consider subscribing and giving a thumbs up below and leaving your comments for more awesome content. Solution number one, right-click on this tray section down here below and select the Task Manager. There are obviously other ways to access the Task Manager with the mouse. I show you just this one here, but have a full description of the others in the cheat sheet. In the Task Manager, you will see different processes running and how much resources they take from the CPU, from the memory, and from the capacity of your computer. For my one, this HP TouchPoint Analytics client was taking almost up to 50% of the memory and the mouse was lagging. Your computer may have this or some other processes tasking the memory heavily when you are actually not using them. To solve this, right-click on the process tasking the memory and then go to End Task. Now, this is usually the one main big issue, and it is very logical that if the computer's capacity is giving away to a high resource using program, and especially one you're not using, it is going to slow down in many ways. Always try this out before moving on to try the next possible 5 solutions. Usually, if you try out the next possible 5 solutions without taking this first ultimate one into consideration, you ultimately will have mouse performance problems again. There are obviously precautions you have to take while doing this. Stopping a process using the Task Manager, it's going to stabilize your computer. However, ending a process can completely close an application or crash your computer based on the process you've closed, and you could lose any unsaved data this way. It is highly recommended, therefore, that you always save your data before killing a process if possible. Solution number two. The reason could be an outdated mouse driver. To solve this, type Device Manager in the search menu and access the Device Manager. Alternatively, right-click on the Windows menu and search for Device Manager. Select the Device Manager, click Mouse and other pointing devices. You can right-click and update the driver, but usually you see here that the most updated version is already installed. If that is the case, we are going to uninstall the driver, take out the mouse transponder or your USB cable, and reinsert it for a new driver to be installed on the fly from the internet. So right-click on the driver and select Uninstall. The precaution you should take here is that you should only uninstall. Do not in any case delete the driver. Take out your mouse transponder or USB cable and then insert it again. Then Windows is going to find and install the latest driver for your mouse. This usually would solve the problem too. In case this does not solve the problem, right-click on the mouse driver, go to Properties and then Driver, and you can roll back the driver to the one that was there. This may solve the problem. Solution number three, left-click on the Windows menu, select Settings, select Devices, select Mouse. For some computers, you have both the mouse and the touchpad lumped up together. Go to Related Settings, Additional Mouse Options. Select Pointer Options, unselect Hide Pointer Device While Typing, and choose OK. Solution number 4. Type in Control Panel in the Windows search menu, select Hardware and Sound, select Power Options, then choose what the power buttons do, and here where it reads Turn on Fast Startup, unselect it, then Save Changes. Solution number 5. Enable or disable scroll inactive windows when I hover over them. Access the settings by typing settings here in the search menu and choosing it, or by left clicking on the Windows menu and selecting settings. Select mouse. Look where it reads. Scroll in active windows when I hover over them. Do disable and enable it again, and your problem may be solved. Solution number 6. The touchpad may be tasking your CPU while you are not actually using it. Alternatively, it may be taking vibrations from your hand and transposing this to the screen and directing the cursor to other places on your screen. An ultimate solution, like in solution number 1, is to turn off such a device you are not using at all. There is a quick way to do this from the keyboard. This is done through one of the function keys, like F1, F2, F3, and so on. You can know which one is applicable for your computer by looking at them. For my one, there is this icon that looks like a touchpad at F4, and since I have the Fn key, I'm going to press it down and then press F4 to turn off my touchpad. The way you know whether you should use Fn and a function key is when you look at the keyboard. For my case, I have this F here, which is very small and hanging up, and I'm having the Fn key down here. So I must use them, in this case Fn and F4, to turn it off. I've looked around for some other computers, and I'll give you a little summary. For HP, you use Fn plus F4, Acer Fn plus F7, Dell Fn plus F3, Lenovo Fn plus F6, Toshiba Fn plus F9. Some keyboards may not have the Fn function. And with this, the function keys are written very boldly. And so you do not need to use the Fn to access the function keys. You just hit them directly. I have given you 6 possible ways here to solve the annoying problems of a lagging mouse. And I have a cheat sheet in the description on using only keyboard shortcuts in case your mouse is no longer working. I hope one of the solutions works for your computer. Thank you for watching. Please also go down to the comment sections and share your experience as to what worked best for you. Please do not forget to leave a thumbs up below and do consider subscribing if you've not yet done so. Otherwise, I look forward to seeing you in another one of my videos. Bye-bye.